Dear students, welcome to our live webinar for today. I can see there are quite a few early birds that we have for today's webinar. So guys, stick around. We're just waiting for a few more minutes to have all other students join us, and we will be starting shortly. A very good evening, my dear students. So we are receiving an overwhelming response of students who are still continuing to join our live webinar for today's crucial topic. So guys, just give us a couple of more minutes, and in just a few short minutes, we will begin our webinar for today. In the meantime, to all the students who are already here with us, I want to let you know, guys, that we do have the Q&A section in today. You can find it probably at the bottom of your screen. And that is the section where you can start asking your questions. We have an esteemed panelist list today here with you to help you answer all your questions that you may have regarding this topic. So you can get started on that and start shooting your questions to us. I request you to not use the chat facility. Please do not use the chat facility, because that is only and only for tech difficulties. And I'd like you to keep all your questions to the Q&A section so that our team of panelists can get to you and can answer all your questions. A very warm welcome to all you students who are here with us today's live webinar on the topic, how to get a professional edge with an advanced engineering degree. Dear students, we have some exciting segments planned for you for today's webinar. We'll be having a short and a crisp presentation from our faculty members on this topic, right after which we will also have a live Q&A section. You heard that right, guys. Exciting round of a live Q&A questions will be taken. Your questions will be taken on the audio with some of our panelist members, as well as your other questions will also be tended to by the rest of our panelists. So with no further ado, let's get into it. But before that, I'd also like to inform you, dear students, that we are currently accepting applications for admissions into our MTech degree here at MIT World Peace University. Log into admissions.mitwpu.edu.in and go ahead and send in your applications for the MTech program. And you want to be an early bird to this process and not delay this, since we are already in a time which is uncertain with the whole COVID-19 pandemic and the lockdown of the country. I also want to take this opportunity to let every single student here with us to let you know and assure you that we are working relentlessly to make sure that the admission process for all of you is as seamless as possible. We are, of course, in the process of formulating policies that will help everyone out, every student out, with their admission process. And if the need arises, the entire admissions process may even go online. That's right, it might happen if the situation doesn't change, and if we still continue to face the difficulties that we are facing right now, we are open to changing the admission process and even taking it online if the need arises. So I urge all of you to keep an eye out on our latest policies that will get published in the next few days on our website. And also feel assured that we are very much here to support you and help you and guide you through this difficult time. On that note, dear students, let's gear up for an exhaustive and detailed presentation on the topic for today, how to get a professional edge with an advanced engineering degree. Dr. Bhutata will be leading this presentation, joined by Dr. Patil. Over to you, Dr. Bhutata.
Thank you, Suchi. Welcome you all for today's webinar on how to get a professional edge with an advanced engineering degree. This is Dr. Dinesh Bhutada from MIT WPU Faculty of Engineering. Welcomes you for today's webinar. Go on the further study. It is a question which students often ponder upon availing bachelor's degree in engineering. In the field of engineering and technology, advanced master degree not only opens door to research opportunities, but also increases the employability as well. And when it comes to attractive advanced master degree program, no one does it better than Dr. Vishwanath Karad, MIT World Peace University, Pune, which was formerly known as Maharashtra Institute of Technology, that is MIT Pune. Now, welcome to the presentation on Faculty of Engineering. As you know, MIT started in 1983, and now under the umbrella of MIRE, there are more than 65 plus institutions and 55,000 plus students currently studying. About the MIT WPU philosophy, the four major pillars on which MIT WPU philosophy stands, that is partnership, social innovations, research, and technology. So about the ranking, so different organizations ranked MIT World Peace University, and it is ranked in silver category by the QS ranking, ranked fifth in a private university category by the Times of India survey, ranked in a top 100 institutes in 2016, 17, and 18 by NIRF. All the programs are indexed and listed in a top private university by Vice President of India in Jagran Josh survey. Also, it is ranked top 10 by Times survey in top private universities, then top 15th in best private institutes for the engineering, and ranked 19th in top engineering institutes in 2019 survey. Yes, about the MIT WPU method. MIT WPU method is formed with a combination of ruler immersion, team teaching, research collaborations, and digital learning technology, sport culture, social missions, national study program, peace programs, fostering entrepreneurship, industrial collaborations for internships, international study program, and alumni involvement. Yes, most important, alumni involvement, because MIT WPU is having more than 1 lakh plus alumni across the globes, which are continuously helping our students in internships, in the placements, and the further learning. So, why MIT? Why MIT WPU M.Tech program? So, MIT WPU believes our graduates should be physically fit, mentally alert, and spiritually elevated. And MIT WPU believes in a value-based education system. Our program includes the peace component, which helps for the personality development of the students. The syllabus is designed with the help of industry, which is includes technology support along with the best industry tie-ups. Yes, we make our student who can think out of our students are encouraged to take up the projects, industry internships, also to participate into competitive technical events. I'm happy to say our many of the laboratories are set up in a MIT WPU campus by the industry itself, like Mahindra and Tata Technology Center, and very recent one, Acre Subsea Lab, is a result of that. Curriculum is delivered through the highly qualified and experienced faculty who are PhD and masters from reputed universities in India and abroad. Our faculty members also keep themselves updated with the current industry trends and technology. And you know, the Pune is an industrial hub. It provides us ample resources for the skill development and industry and international partnership. Now I hand over it to my colleague, Dr. H.R. Magar Patil, sir, for the next slide.
Good evening, my dear students. This is Professor Dr. H.R. Magar Patil, faculty in Civil Engineering Department, and I am also in charge of admissions of M.Tech in MIT Bulpes University. If you see PG in engineering, actually in all branches we are having specializations. Like civil engineering, we have structural engineering with intake capacity of 24, construction engineering and management with the intake capacity of 24, tunnel engineering, this is a unit 18. Computer engineering, if you see, there are three specializations again. Data science and analytics, it is having intake capacity of 24. Network management and cybersecurity, it is having intake capacity of 18. High performance computing, this is also having intake capacity of 18. As far as mechanical engineering is concerned, design engineering is having intake capacity of 24. Thermal engineering is having intake capacity of 18. CAD-CAM and CAE is having also intake capacity of 18. Now, electronics and communication engineering, we offers two specializations like VLSI and embedded systems having intake capacity of 18. Communication network systems is having intake capacity of 18. Now, as far as petroleum engineering and polymer engineering, these are schools. Along with schools, they are also offering degrees in petroleum engineering with capacity of 18, intake capacity of 18, and polymer engineering with capacity of 18. Now, we'll see branches in detail. School of Computer Engineering, as I said earlier, School of Computer Engineering and Technology provides specialization in data science and analytics, network management and cybersecurity, and high performance computing. If you see this department has a grants, ongoing grants of 60 lakh rupees. As far as research publications are concerned, in last 10 years, they have published almost 750 plus papers in international journals and 650 plus papers in conferences. Also, I'm proud to tell you that they have obtained 32 Indian patents as well as 2 Indian copyrights. As far as research facilities in these departments are concerned, this department has all labs well equipped with equipments. And if you see network and cybersecurity lab, data science and analytic labs, high performance computing lab, IBM Center of Excellence. So this is a proud IBM center, which is having sponsored by IBM only. NVIDIA lab, embedded systems lab, and likewise, there are so many laboratories in computer engineering and technology. Research project areas, if you see in machine learning, deep learning, medical image, and health informatics, network security, wireless sensor networks, etc. So these are the highlights. Here I want to make a mention that high performance computing is also, this syllabus is set by CDAC, as well as students are going to get their internships in second year in CDAC only. Next, please. As far as School of Civil Engineering is concerned, MTech specializations are, as I told earlier, three specializations we offer: construction engineering and management, structural engineering is second specialization, and tunnel engineering is third specialization. As far as tunnel engineering is concerned, this is a unique branch all over India. Nowhere you can find this MTech in tunnel engineering. This is a unique course. Now, as far as funding is concerned in civil engineering, we are having funding of 85 lakhs. Some ongoing projects are there. Expert faculties are 40 plus. Alumni globally in this department is 50,000 plus. Research publications and patents from this department are 500 plus. Highest CTC in this department for MTech is 9 lakhs, whereas average CTC is 5 lakhs. Now, as far as research facilities in this department available are research laboratories, Indo-Italian Center of Excellence, and it also provides, this department also provides consultancy services, as well as commercial testing house is one of the asset in this department. Our air quality monitoring and research station is also a big thing to mention here, because this is the unique station we have developed in our institute, and it provides data all over the country. If you see the research facilities available in the department, our laboratories are well equipped with pre-stressing yard. This is a unique yard which is not available in many of the institutes in Maharashtra and India. Impact testing machine, which is developed and established in MIT only, and many PhD students from various universities are working using this impact testing machine. As far as dynamic servo shake table is concerned, this is a unique servo shake table which is available in the department, which also directly works with actual earthquake timestamp records. So you can apply actual timestamp records to the building models, and you can check the developments and behavior of building frames. Now, loading frame with 200 ton capacity is also one of the thing to mention here. Skill-based certificate courses are the things which are required to mention here, like Primavera, StatPro, then ANSYS, NISA Civil, ETABS. These are the various skill-based certificate courses we provide from civil engineering department. Now, as far as electronics and communication engineering department is concerned, as I told earlier, we provide two specializations. One is VLSI and embedded systems. Second is communication networks and software. As far as grants are concerned, ongoing projects of cost 90 lakh rupees are going on presently in this department. Research publications in last 5 years are published more than 300 plus international papers, 400 plus conference papers, and obtained 13 in Indian patents and 2 copyrights. As far as research facilities are concerned, this department has advanced laboratories with well equipments and softwares. If you see research facilities, advanced VLSI lab with tools like Cadence, then Mentor Graphics, advanced embedded system, and DSP lab, and many more. As far as research projects are going on in this department are AI machine learning, then automotive electronics, agro electronics, healthcare, and etc. So many research projects are also going on in this department.
Okay, guys, now, before we proceed further, I would just like to make a quick announcement on the presentations. Of course, sir is taking us through a detail of every single specialization, all the 13 specializations in MTech that we give here at MIT World Peace University. I can see that lots of students are buzzing with questions. And dear students, I'd like to remind you to keep your questions onto the Q&A section of the webinar. Please avoid using the chat facility. I repeat, do not ask your questions in the chat facility. Instead, take your questions into the Q&A section, and our team of panelists today will definitely have those answered. We just have a few quick minutes of the presentation remaining, and after which we are going to jump into the live Q&A segment of this webinar, wherein we take your questions and have them answered by our panelists here today. Back to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. As far as School of Mechanical Engineering is concerned, we offer 3 specializations like Design Engineering, Thermal Engineering, and CAD/CAM CAE. Now, in this department, 75 plus expert faculties are there, 20 IPRs are also there in this department, and 8800 plus research publications in this department. This is a unique department which is well equipped with machines like diffused light polariscope, hydraulic fatigue testing machine, 4 ball tester, wear and friction monitor, vibration meter, multi-channel FFT analyzer. Also, if you see the research areas in this department is NVH, optimization of manufacturing process, solar energy, computational fluid dynamics. These are the biggest achievements of this department. As far as get hand-on training in line with Industry 4.0, with 3D printing, industrial robots, laser cutting machine, vertical machine center, and automated conveyor systems. So these are the unique points of mechanical engineering departments. Next. Now, as far as polymer engineering department, this is a unique department. If you see Western Maharashtra, this is a unique department. Nowhere you will find this degree available in BTech level as well as MTech level. This department or school also provides MTech degree in polymer engineering only. If you see, current research areas in this department are like green composites, blends, processing, process simulation, and synthesis. Grants received in this department almost 1 crore and 57 lakhs are going on under UK Innovative and DBT Government of India. Ongoing projects are development of biofresh pack material. Now, research publications, numerous research publications in international as well as national journals are there. Also, one thing to mention here is 6 patents have been filed in this department. Now, research facilities in this department are excellent facilities for polymer processing, polymer synthesis, polymer testing, characterization, and polymer compounding, etc. Now, this is our last school, School of Petroleum Engineering. As I mentioned about polymer engineering, School of Petroleum Engineering also provides M.Tech degree in petroleum engineering. This is a unique department because in all over India, you will not find this department and which is not providing a degree in petroleum engineering. So unique features of this department is this department has alumni from chemical engineering, mechanical engineering, instrumentation engineering, mining engineering, geosciences background are working in top of the institutes or E&P services industries. This department has unique subsea engineering laboratory also. Now about this department, grant received are 1.75 crores, which includes the DST grant available from Government of India. Now research publications, faculty members published 27 plus research papers in reputed national and international journals and conferences. Now research facilities available in this department are like these laboratories are well equipped with the equipments which are sponsored from Computer Management Group Canada, Halliburton Landmark USA, Emerson Roxer Norway, Petroleum Expert Limited UK, Aspen USA, Carbocarbo Ceramics, IHS USA, Kappa Engineering USA, Intigraph USA. Now research facilities, research areas in this department are reservoir characterization, petroleum geosciences, well testing, etc. Now, as I mentioned that Dr. Vishwanath Karad Center for Subsea Engineering, this is a unique laboratory available in this department. The total costing of this laboratory is 10 crore. Now, students from petroleum engineering, polymer engineering, civil engineering, mechanical engineering, computer engineering, and electronics engineering do their research work using this laboratory. Various equipments costing around 7 crores are available in this laboratory. This laboratory is active now. Many students from M.Tech as well as PhD doing research in this laboratory. Now, our domain-based laboratory, which is required to be mentioned here, these laboratories from mechanical or other departments are having sponsored equipments from Tata Technologies Limited and Mahindra & Mahindra. Like this Bravo robot, you can see, and as well as vertical machining center available in mechanical engineering department. Now about symposium, this is a unique thing which happens in MIT World Peace University as far as postgraduate students are concerned, because this thing is very important to mention here. The students who are doing research work in second year of their M.Tech, they have to present their research work in front of the eminent faculties from unique universities or eminent universities like IITs, NITs, or RECs, IISCs also, and industry people like from Tata Technologies, Thermax, then Wipro, like that. So these, in front of all these experts, students present their research work. Also, they get input and they can develop their research work. We have found that while giving information during this symposium, many industrialists, they offers their job directly to the students who are presenting their research work. Now, I request Dr. Bhutada to take the session now.
Thank you, Dr. Patil, sir. Again, coming to the technical events in MIT World Peace University, MIT World Peace University always encourages for participation outside campus. Just like Smart India Hackathon, which was in 2019, our team won first prize and our team won many prizes in the hackathon. You can see here. There were different software complex categories in which our team won the first prize, which was organized by MHRD AICTE. Also, in Singapore India Hackathon in 2018, our team won third prize and got the prize at the hand of Honorable Prime Minister. And there were many prizes in 2018 in hackathons which are organized at the different places. There was a hackathon organized by the Niti Aayog Pune Smart City Hackathon, in which our student won second prize. Yes, this is a very, very interesting. Our student made this robo. This is called as the Chintu robo. And this robo is made in our lab by our student and faculty member. And I am happy to say this robo is got patented and our students are working with this humanoid robo. Another achievement with the chemical engineering department, our AICHE chapter, that is American Institute of Chemical Engineers, MITWPU chapter, got outstanding chapter award in 2019 in Florida, Orlando, USA. And there are many clubs in MIT World Peace University like Team PRT, Team Acceleration, Team Aggravator, Team Bolt, Team Skyproper. These all clubs help students to develop their technical skill and also to work on to the teams which are run by the industry. Now, the team Robocon, this is a very important. This is the robot competition which is organized in MIT World Peace University since long time. And these robots are made by our students. And this is a level on the national and international level. There are many laboratories which are set up by the industry onto the campus, like Persistent Center of Excellence, IBM Center of Excellence, IEEE Affordable Agriculture Technology Laboratory. These all laboratories are set up by the industry onto the campus of MIT WPU. There are many industry academia tie-ups. These are tie-ups for the placements, for the internships, for the industrial visits, for the guest lectures. You can see the logos of the tie-ups for the internships. These internships are in an area of civil engineering, petroleum engineering, polymer engineering, computer engineering, chemical engineering, and computer science and engineering. We always encourage our students to take them to visit different industries in Maharashtra and even in outside Maharashtra. Here, we arrange many seminars, guest lecture, interactive sessions. We also arrange many international conferences and workshops to enhance the knowledge of students and our faculty members. There are many sports facilities are available onto our campus. You can see there are many student achievements are there in technical areas. Our student won a second prize in electric vehicle design. You can see here, there are other few achievements you can see at a different level. Again, I hand over it to Dr. Magar Patil for the next presentation.
Thank you, Dr. Bhutada. Now, this is a main thing which is available on the screen right now. Basically, I want to make a mention before going to fee structure and other tentative schedule. I want to make a mention that ours is a choice-based credit system wherein students can choose their subjects as well as they can also select their teachers. So this is a unique thing which is there. Also, ours is a continuously updated system wherein our syllabus committee is along with the industry personalities. So this is a unique thing which happens in our institute. Now, about annual fees and tentative schedule here, tuition fees mentioned here, total fees is 1,90,000. Out of 1,90,000, tuition fees is 1,33,000 and other fees is 57,000. Now about tentative schedule mentioned here, this is subject to change because of present scenario is happening worldwide because of COVID-19. You can pay the fees in installments. So that is one more thing is required to be added here. Now this is a unique thing what is required to mention here. As far as MIT World Peace University is concerned, and that too MTech education, we provide stipend to the students for having non-zero positive GATE score. Now, about the students who are having positive GATE score more than 5 and less than 15, we are providing a GATE stipend of 4,000 rupees. Now, the students who are having GATE score more than 15 and less than GATE qualifying score, as far as general category is concerned, we provide a stipend of 5,000 rupees. And the students who are GATE qualified, that means they have cracked GATE score they will get the stipend of 6,000 rupees. But here I want to make a mention that the students who are getting stipend, they will get the workload. Now, for the students who are eligible to get the stipend of 6,000 rupees, they will get the teaching workload of 8 hours per week. The students who are getting stipend of 5,000 rupees, they will get a teaching workload of 6 hours per week. And the students who are getting a stipend of 4,000 rupees, they will get the stipend of, they will get a workload of 4 hours per week. It is required to mention here, this stipend is subject to many limiting conditions. Like this stipend is available for the all category students, and as far as these marks are concerned. So from 5 marks to get qualifying marks of general category students will get the stipend. Now it is applicable to first year MTech students only. Then it is required to mention here, stipend will be given as per GATE score mentioned above by considering the score cutoff of general category student of respective UG category as well as GATE category engineering branches. Last year, 2019-20, we provided the scholarship and stipend of rupees 7 crores to the MIT World Peace University students. As far as eligibility is concerned, the University Grant Commission rules are there, but we provide the admission to the students who have passed a bachelor's degree with the percentage of 50% in final year of their engineering in general category students. And as far as the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes or tribe students are concerned, they just passed the final year and with non-zero positive GATE score and without non-zero positive GATE score, they can apply in MIT World Peace University. Now, eligibility and admission procedure is concerned, the non-zero positive GATE score candidates can directly apply to the to the MIT World Peace University. And as I have mentioned earlier, they will get the stipend as mentioned. Now, as far as second category is concerned, the sponsor category, wherein the students who are having 2 years of experience, they can also apply under sponsored category. As you know that in MIT, MTech admissions, there is a separate quota for sponsored category students. The students who are having minimum 2 years of experience, they can apply under this category. Now, if the student is sponsored category and along with that, if he is having GATE score, he will be preferred first. Second important thing which is required to mention here that the sponsored category student applications are more than the seats available in the department. In that case, we will take written test for the sponsored category students followed by interview, and then we'll declare the merit list, and according to that, they can get the admission. One more thing required to mention here that the students who are not having GATE score or negative GATE score, or the students who have not applied for GATE examination, or they have not appeared for the GATE admission, they can also apply in MIT World Peace University for getting admission. Now, for any vacant seat after above process means the students who are having positive non-zero score and then sponsored category, the remaining seat, vacant seats, for those remaining seat, non-zero, the students who are not having GATE score, they can apply and they can get the admission through the process of written test followed by interview in the respective school. Now about placement is concerned, 200 plus companies visits MIT World Peace University every year. Now as far as the CTC package is concerned, our MTech students have received package of 24 lakhs per annum and average package of 6.5 lakh average per annum. Now, the company's logos you can see here on right-hand side, like Sigma, Oracle, KPIT, these companies, Tata Consulting Services, these all companies also comes here for the placement. Also, these are the few logos you can see. These all companies visits MIT World Peace University for the placement. Now about campus life, we have the auditorium where the cultural events go on, a big auditorium with a capacity of 700 plus seats. And we have also a court for football, cricket, basketball, and also the table tennis. Also, we provide the facilities for Robocon, as well as we have the World Peace Library, wherein the students can study the other than engineering subjects. Now, to contact MIT and to get the admission, you can see here, these all contact details you can see. Also, you can click on the link which is provided here on right hand side, and also there is a QR code available on this slide. You can go through this QR code as well as link to get the admission in MIT World Peace University.
All right, so that was the end of the presentation, guys, and we are going to jump into the live Q&A section. But before that, once again, I can see there has been an overwhelming response from all you students. Please go ahead and continue asking your questions, and we will be happy to answer all of them. And once again, if you must know, we are taking admissions currently in the M.Tech degree. There are 13 specializations available. So chances are we have something available for which caters to your interest. So do go ahead and check out those details at admissions.mitwpu.edu.in. And guys, let's not be late in sending our admissions for this program. Since we are already going through an uncertain time, it will help us to get in touch with you and guide you further as to what the next steps of admission and selection process would be. And of course, I would like to assure you that we are working round the clock to make sure that the admission process is completely streamlined so that we can help every single one of you make the maximum out of it. On the screen right now, you can also see that we are putting up a few answers to questions which we have received from students. These were the most frequently asked students asked questions from students, and we did work on a Word document, and we are posting those answers there. So you can also quickly skim through that if you have interest. Now on to our most exciting segment, which is our live Q&A round. For this, we will be joined by Dr. Dinesh Bhutata, Dr. Patil, and Neeta ma'am. So I request panelist members that I've mentioned to please come on your video so that students can also see you today. Okay, Neeta ma'am, if we could have you as well, it would be great. All right, so you can see our esteemed faculty members here who are especially here for you today. So we will be beginning with the questions. Amok asks us, is there a placement guarantee for the M.Tech degree in structural engineering specialization?
Okay, so I can answer this question as I belong to civil engineering department. Amol,
yes,
Amol, structural engineering is the basic branch which is started in 1998. And we have good rapport with industry, and very importantly, consultancy as well as the testing facility available in our department is great to make a mention here. Our laboratories and the facilities available and the syllabus set here is along with the help of the industry personalities. As far as placement is concerned, placement is 100% as far as structural engineering is concerned. We provide 100% placement to the students. Now the package, as I mentioned here, is changes from 5 lakhs minimum package to the 9 lakhs maximum package, which we have observed in last 2 years.
Okay, great. So we have our next question. Prem asks us, when will the merit list be declared?
Merit list will be declared on the just 2 days before the round of admission round. So around it will be declared on 20th of July.
Again, I would like to add here, actually, it is again subject to declaration of result for the graduation. As you know, the current process is already delayed and already lot of exams are now extended actually or postponed. Because of that, again, you need to keep in touch with our website to check the dates, actually, official dates. So I suggest everyone to keep in touch with the website for this.
Okay, great. So there you heard it, students. While you have a tentative date there from Sir, we are open to a few changes if necessary so that we can accommodate all students. Everyone is facing an uncertain time at this point with their exams and their declaration and their results. So definitely we want to streamline the admission process to help every single one of you. There will be policies we will be coming out in a few days. So I recommend that you check out our website. We are also accepting admission applications at this point for our M.Tech degree with 13 different specializations. So go ahead and go on to admissions.mitwpu.edu.in. So our next question for the day is from Yashwant. I want to pursue M.Tech in CSE, but I have a background in mechanical engineering. Is there a way for me to join the M.Tech in the CSE specialization?
Yashwant, actually for the CSE specialization, the eligibility is from the CSE itself or IT and allied fields. But the mechanical students is not eligible to apply for CSE actually, as per the eligibility criteria of AICTE.
Okay, I hope that answers your question. Shivani asks us today, what is the maximum and minimum package for the electronic and telecommunications stream in engineering at MIT WPU?
In electronics and telecommunication engineering, last year students have got package of 9 lakh rupees and minimum package of 5 lakh rupees.
Okay. So we have the next question today from Sai Krishna. He asks us, how does the placement process apply for the working professional?
As far as working professional is concerned, if he is applying through sponsored category, then no need to get the interviewed here in MIT World Peace University, because they are working professional and they are applying through sponsored category. And if he is not applying through sponsored category and he is applying as a GATE candidate with non-zero positive score or non-GATE candidate, then he also get the facility to sit for the interview and get placed in through MIT World Peace University.
Okay, great. So we have Jay Khare asking us his next question. I already have a job lined up after completing my BE this year. Just a second, I'm just trying to find his question here.
Suchi, I've got it if I can ask that. Jay Khare is asking, I already have a job lined up after BE this year and my friends and others are preferring to join the job and not go for PG. What would you suggest considering current global recession and other world events?
I would like to give answer to Jay's question actually. It is always better for going for higher education and pursuing higher education during the global slowdown right now. You can understand there is a global slowdown situation and it is always preferable to secure a higher education. And once the market goes in normal way, we can again jump up into the job actually. Because right now you are in that phase that you can complete your post graduation and you can again come back into the job. And I will suggest you should must go for higher education in this current situation actually.
Okay, so next question we have from Pratik, who asks us, in thermal engineering, do we get any international exposure?
As far as international exposure is concerned, we give the facility, all documentary requirements we can provide as far as MIT World Peace University is concerned. Also, we assist him from the documentary as well as the faculty point of view. So this is the international scenario, and internationally it is possible. If it is possible, we also provide the all other details also. Please go through MIT World Peace University website.
Okay. Okay, is there any internship program for second year in the data science and analytics stream?
Okay, so data science and analytics stream, we provide internship. So 100% internship we provide every year. So in last 3 years since MIT World Peace University is established, so we have provided 100% internship to all the students of MTech, those who are admitted in MIT World Peace University. So there is no question of getting internship from MIT World Peace University as far as DSA is concerned. So he will definitely get internship.
Okay, great. If a student already has global certifications, is that student applicable to get stipend?
I didn't got this question actually. Global certification means, I didn't right. Got that.
Okay. So Shivam Mishra, I think this was your question. If you can just expand on your question once again as to what global certifications you are talking about, it will allow sir to further answer your question. Praneet Joshi asks us, can I take admission as an external student?
No, we don't provide the admission for external student. It is full-time course and they have to attend the college full-time. We provide facility. Now, this year we have started for the branches like polymer engineering, for petroleum engineering, DSA, data science analytics, then NMCS, HPC, as well as we have provided facility to CAD-CAM, CAE and thermal engineering. That weekend classes will be there. So from Thursday to Sunday, the classes will be there. So actual teaching will be going on Saturday and Sunday. And on Thursday and Friday, there will be lab work. They can do their laboratory work over there. So this is a facility what we can provide them. But external admission is not allowed in MIT. They have to attend the classes.
Right.
Okay. Is last year's GATE score valid for this year's admission?
Yes, GATE score of 2018, 2019 and 2020 is eligible to apply. That means last 3 years GATE score is valid.
Okay, great. For second year, is it compulsory to do internships?
Yeah, it is the part of curriculum. It is the part of structure. So second year, they have internship of 3 months at least. They can extend it up to 6 months, but it is there in their hand. They can go for it. And along with that, they can do their research project also. And very importantly, in second year MTech, we provide the web-based courses. So they can select their courses on their own. They can study and they can directly give the examination online. So courses, MOOC courses, they can apply for that. They can give examination and they can pass into those. So it is not needed to come into the college, MIT. They can be in touch with their research guide and also they can do internship in wherever they are getting.
Okay, great. Do students get scholarship in the second year of the MTech degree?
The stipends which are mentioned here, those are eligible for first year only. So for first year FY MTech only, these stipends are available. From second year onwards, those are not available. But I want to make a mention here that the students who are get qualified, they will continue getting their scholarship from AICTE, which is 12,400 rupees. It was there last year. This year, we don't know the actual amount and what is the scenario in AICTE, but they will get for 2 years, those who have get qualified.
Okay. Another student asks us, I have a GATE score of 30 along with 3 years of experience. Can I directly get admission into the MTech degree at MIT WPU?
Yes, he can definitely get the admission. GATE score he has 30 is a good score, as well as he's having experience of 3 years. So he can get admission in as a sponsored candidate, as well as he can get admission in GATE category directly.
We suggest him to apply on our website because the application process is already on, and we suggest he should apply on our website.
All right. So we have Shivam Mishra asking us, I'm already working in the cyber security field and do not have time to prepare for the GATE exam. So what is the eligibility criteria for me?
In this case, if he has not given the GATE examination, he can apply in MIT Vulpes University for MTech admission. Definitely, he may get the admission in MIT Vulpes University, even if he has not given GATE examination. What he can do, apply online in MIT Vulpes University, then on the date of admission, he can come here prepared by studying the syllabus from second year to final year of his engineering, and he can give a written test followed by interview. And if the seats remains vacant from GATE candidate students as well as from sponsored category students, he will definitely get the admission as per the ranking or merit which the students were not given the GATE examination.
Okay. Manoj asks us, what are the kind of job offers that students get after completing the MTech degree in civil in construction management?
In construction and management specialization, most probably student gets project management category jobs. So project management in various fields like Hindustan constructions, like Shahpurji Palanji, many students have got the jobs, and our construction management specialization provides 100% job placement.
Okay. What is the average stipend for a computer engineering internship?
As far as internship is concerned, it depends on the company where he is getting selected. So stipend is given by the company itself. So if that company is giving stipend, then it's okay. Otherwise, he has to work on his own. So stipend is completely based on the company.
Okay. Satish asks us, can the fees be paid in stages?
Yes, Satish, you can pay the fees in stages. There are installments to pay the fees. At the start, there will be fees to be paid at the time of seat allotment. And afterwards, there will be two installments actually to finish the complete amount of 1,90,000. Yeah.
Okay. Jay asks us, does MIT WPU provide internship support? If yes, what kind of support is exactly provided?
Definitely, we provide support for internship. We provide the support from the placement scenario. Placement department works on it. And every year, we have provided 100% internship. So we have provided internship in good companies, which we have shown in our presentation. So if you see, in companies like ARAI, we have provided Tata Technologies Limited, then Mahindra & Mahindra, and then Shahpurji Palanji. So such companies, students get selected for the internship.
If I can just add over there, we do have a central team, Center of Industry Academy Partnerships, which has got internships as one of its wings, and they help the faculty and students find the right internships. It's not just about any internship on the right company. We do get a lot of good companies, just like Sir mentioned right now. But it's also about what is the project which is undertaken. Right. So we try to match the student profile as a university. We try and find that the right match of the company and the student profile as much as possible. And quite often we've seen what's called in university parlance, a pre-placement offer. So a person completing an internship at a particular company quite often gets a pre-placement offer without sitting through proper placement process, gets an offer for a job there only.
Okay, great. Jatin asks us, how is your degree different from the one provided at NICMAR? Apart from providing the master's degree, what are some of the other MIWPU advantages that your institute provides?
As far as NICMAR is concerned, the same parallel degree we also provide in construction, engineering, and management. Our course is a unique course because the syllabus of construction, engineering, and management is set by the eminent faculties from IITs, NITs, MIT World Peace Universities, and industrial personalities. So industrial personnel come here and they attend meetings after every 6 months, and it is a continuous updating system in MIT World Peace University, we always update our syllabus. So the syllabus is fulfilling the requirement of industry. So actually we directly place the student to industries. We have found in last so many years that the students who are doing internship in various companies, those companies itself gives them offer for the job. So this is the best thing which happens about MIT World Peace University students. So construction, engineering, and management, we have seen this thing in a major manner.
Okay. Abdul asks us, are sponsorship seats available?
Yes, sponsorship is also available. Sponsorship in the for the job placement or what? He is asking about what?
I think Avdhut want to ask about is sponsorship available into the admission process. So Avdhut, yes, sponsorships are available into the admission process. I suggest you should apply on our website in a sponsored category.
Okay,
yeah, great. I want to add here, sponsored yes. Quota is there. As far as AICT and UGC grant, UGC is available, is concerned, separate sponsored quota is available for MTech. So if there is an intake of 18, there is a separate sponsor quota. So they can apply through that sponsor quota and they will definitely get admission over there.
Right.
Okay, great. Aditya asks us, for the counseling rounds, will my knowledge in CAD softwares be considered?
Yeah, definitely. He's in counseling round, like when he is giving the interview, if he has not given GATE examination, then in a written test followed by interview, he will be asked a question according to in which branch he is interested and the knowledge which is he's having. So definitely the questions will be asked according to that.
Okay. Pratik asks us, we all know the current scenario of mechanical engineering. What will be your guidelines if I want to go with thermal engineering? Will that be a good choice in this current scenario?
Yes, definitely. Thermal engineering is a unique branch in MIT World Peace University. It is a branch which offers degree which is not available in other institutes. And we have seen that students from thermal engineering have got placed in companies like Thermax, as well as Mahindra & Mahindra and Tata Technologies, Bharat Forge. So many jobs are available, and this degree is a great achievement for him.
Great. Rushikesh asks us, What about the M.Tech in petrochemical engineering? Does it have good placements, and do the students in this stream acquire good placements and internships?
Rishikesh, I would like to suggest you, the course provided in MIT is M.Tech in petroleum engineering. It is not course in petrochemical. It is a course in petroleum engineering, for which students from chemical, polymer, then again petroleum are eligible to apply actually. So here there are lot many companies are coming for placements, like Schlumberger, Kane, then there is a ONGC is there which regularly visits for the placement opportunity. So I suggest you to apply on our website. And I would like to suggest another thing. This is a unique program in Maharashtra. None other than MIT World Peace University provides M.Tech in petroleum engineering. And this is a very means job oriented course, I will suggest, because the our alumni are spread over all means like other countries, like you can say USA, UK and all oil producing countries, where our alumni are there, which always support the M.Tech students for the placement activity. And the package wise, if you say, the highest package in M.Tech is from petroleum engineering itself. So there is a lot of scope is available for the students to get the placement after once the program is finished. So I suggest to apply on our website.
Okay, great. So guys, that's it for our live Q&A round for today. That was an exhaustive round. Lots of important questions were answered. And I really, really hope that this session was very helpful for you. I also want to remind you, of course, right now, dear students, we are in fact and indeed currently accepting applications in M.Tech program at MIT World Peace University. So dear students, please go ahead and log into admissions.mitwpu.edu.in and select the program of your choice. Under M.Tech, we have 13 specializations. So go ahead and make your choice and send in your applications. Let's not delay this process. If you become early birds in this admission procedure, it will allow us and help us to help you. We can get in touch with you and send you even more relevant information as to the rest of the selection process and the entire admission procedure that will ensue. On that note, dear students, we will be concluding our webinar for today. I would love to hear your feedback. So I will be launching the student feedback poll right now. So dear students, go ahead and share your feedback with us. And you know, we would be taking your feedback seriously, and we hope to come up with another series of webinars which will be even more helpful for all of you. So do keep an eye out for that. And of course, I also want to inform all of you, dear students, that this webinar recording will also be available on YouTube in a couple of days' time. So go to the MIT World Peace University official YouTube page and look out for this webinar on the M.Tech program. It will be uploaded in a couple of days, and you will have all this information with you for future reference as well. All right, guys, I can see that 64% of you have voted already. So we will be waiting just a couple of more minutes so all our dear students can share their valuable feedback with us. I hope most of you have had the chance to go through our website, but dear students, just to let you know, it's the syllabus, the placement record for every single specialization of M.Tech is available very much on our website. So go ahead and explore mitwpu.edu.in. And of course, another reminder to assure you that we have your needs in mind while we are navigating through our admissions process this year, and we would like to make the process as seamless for you as possible. All right, 85% votes in, just a few more to go. That's it, dear students, from us here today. I wish you a safe stay. Continue to stay indoors, guys. And I hope the session was very helpful for you. And we look forward to connecting with you again in the future.